plush new buildings in Sarajevo, but it's a facade. Real life for most of Bosnia is not as bright. It's one of the poorest countries in Europe, has high rates of youth unemployment, widespread corruption and a fraught political framework. With the Sarajevo Philharmonic Orchestra playing Mozart's 25th Symphony, a special COVID-restricted online celebration marked the official signing of the Dayton peace agreement that ended the war. Bill Clinton, who was US president at the time, lauded the achievement.
The nightmare you endured then has never returned. And the credit for that achievement belongs to all the people of all backgrounds.
The peace deal ended the bloodiest conflict in Europe since the Second World War, but it didn't kickstart the process of reconciliation or renew the ethnic cohabitation enjoyed in pre-war Bosnia.
Had the Dayton Agreement been implemented, we would have had a much better situation today. What is being implemented is still genocide here, because there is a status quo.
In an effort to reverse the ethnic cleansing, the Dayton Accords stated that everyone had the right to return to their homes or to get compensation. That has never happened. The Serbs control 49% of the country, and for them, Dayton was a good deal. But Ljubiša Ćosić, the newly elected mayor of East Sarajevo, says 80% of Bosnian Serbs would vote for independence if they had the chance.
I'm not thinking about that, but if different counterparts, different sides, Bosniaks and Croats, if they want to have a centralized state where the majority of Bosniaks will brought all decisions to Serbs and to other nations, yes, I'm going to say that's not possible.
The Dayton Agreement has been criticized because it appeared to reward the Serbs for aggression by legitimizing their territory, Republika Srpska. Despite the atrocities committed on all sides during the conflict, there have been hardly any revenge killings or inter-ethnic violence. But with many unresolved issues, especially the prosecution of war criminals, according to some, there's tension.
The sparks that lurks here in Bosnia is very dangerous. It should not be here.
What has been done is often harder to undo. Dayton unintentionally cemented the division of the country. Most don't know how injustice will be solved, but they do know that Bosnia can never go back to what it was, where no one looked at a religion, but only a person. The lack of opportunities here has led 1.8 million Bosnians to leave the country. There are both positive and negative aspects to the Dayton Agreement, depending on your point of view, but ultimately it stopped the war and ended the bloodshed. The question that has to be asked is whether the fault for the lack of progress and reconciliation lies with the agreement or the Bosnians themselves. And the answer is probably both. Tony Birtley, Al Jazeera, Sarajevo.